Vanessa and I have returned to work after a good Christmas break. It's so nice to get back into a routine, and I can't wait to reveal some of the things we've been working on very soon. Back at home, there's a few things I want to do this afternoon. I really enjoy cleaning and organising. For me, it's one of the ways I like to relax and unwind after a busy day. And I must always have flowers. I went shopping this morning to buy more things to help me get organised at home. I've gotten a little addicted to watching Organising on YouTube and definitely feel inspired to improve my organisation at home. I did quite a lot of entertaining at the end of 2021, so it's time to clean out my fridge, a task I never enjoy, but which always brings a sense of satisfaction when it's done. I'm going to use baking soda, lemon and sea salt to clean my sink. This is a tip I've picked up from my YouTube bin sessions. It really does work very well. I'm sorry. Not just because it's a new year, but I've been trying to really be careful with my diet. I'm trying to be very healthy, but I have a sweet tooth, so I like to make things that I would normally eat, but more of a healthy version. So what I've been doing a lot over the last 2 years is a lot of keto-based recipes, which I find just helps me to keep in shape, not gain too many extra pounds, and if I do, I can easily get them off. This little recipe that I'm going to share with you is something that I like to make. It is a chocolate candy bar made with nuts, peanut butter oil, coconut oil, and then what I like to call fake sugar, which is kind of like xylitol. And I make this, you don't have to bake it, it's made in the freezer. I chop it into little squares, and then when I'm having my afternoon cup of tea or something like that, and I just fancy a sweet treat, I can take a little square out and just have one a day, and that will satisfy me and get rid of any of those cravings. I have some 70% chocolate, peanut butter, and organic coconut oil. I'm going to heat these together for 50-second intervals in the microwave until everything is melted together. To this melted mixture, I'm adding in some chopped nuts and the fake sugar. I'll stir all this together and pour into a baking dish lined with parchment paper and then leave it to set in the freezer for about an hour. And now this is going to go into the freezer for an hour until it is set, and that is it. When it comes to New Year's resolutions, I don't really like to make them because I think what tends to happen is that you're kind of put on the spot. People ask you at New Year's parties, what are your resolutions? And you come up with a few and maybe a little list of wildly picked out things that probably aren't going to happen. And then after a week of being in a new year, you realize that it's not going as you planned and you become disillusioned. So I learned many years ago not to do that. So if anybody asks me if I have New Year's resolutions, I just tell them that I don't do them. Instead, what I like to do, which is what I've been doing the past few weeks since the New Year started, is really reflect on my life and look at the good and the bad and what I want to improve and what I'm happy with, and then analyze that and make changes to do things that will improve my life. This way I can then make a fully actionable plan about how I can make these changes and kind of split them up into quarters. So I don't make a plan for the whole year. Instead, I make it for perhaps the first 3 months of the year so that I can focus on that period of time and not get overwhelmed with a huge list and a huge goal. I think if you work in quarters, that will help you feel more relaxed and take less of the pressure away from you. I also find that even just making one big change in your life can help you achieve a lot of other things that you may want to do. For example, for me, I think that one of the things that is not so good in my life is that every morning when I wake up, the first thing I do is grab my phone and check Instagram, social media, and before I know, an hour is gone and I'm still scrolling, and that is one thing that I cannot stand. Another thing that I really wanted to achieve in my life is to start doing more things for myself for pleasure. So one of those is reading more. I used to read a lot of books when I was younger. As I've got older,
I've made the excuse that there isn't any time, but really that's untrue. I have many, many hours in the day, especially in the evenings and in the mornings when I could probably read for half an hour, but I don't. So when I mentioned earlier that I think it can take one big change in your life to make lots of other things happen, this is what I mean. So I figured out that if I started waking up earlier, all of those things that are not working in my life or that I want to add into it, I can do by waking up earlier. So, for the past 2 weeks, I've been setting myself the challenge of waking up at 5 a.m. and in those few hours before 9 a.m. when I start working, I've got 4 extra hours to do exactly what I want to do. Now, it would be pretty pointless to wake up at 5 a.m. and then spend 2 hours scrolling through Instagram. So what I've made myself do is, as soon as I've stopped the alarm on my phone, is to put the phone down, keep it on airplane mode, get into the shower, get dressed, have my morning tea, take Sophie for a walk, and not pick up the phone until all of those things are done. Because otherwise, I know what I'm like, I will scroll through, laying in bed, and then those 2 hours will be gone and it will be wasted. So I made the effort to be productive in the morning, get up very early. It was quite difficult at first, but actually, my trick is to put the phone at the other end of the room so that when the alarm goes off, you have to get out of the bed into the cold air, and then you give yourself a reward of a nice hot shower, and then that is something to look forward to when you get out your bed. And I promise, as soon as you have finished your shower, the desire to get back in bed is completely gone. You're fully awake and ready to start the day. So that has worked very well for me, and it's given me 4 hours extra in the mornings to do exactly what I want before starting work. So that big change in my life has enabled me to tick off some of the things that I want to do with the rest of my list. So I can start reading more books, or I can start a new skill, learn something new. So one change creating other changes. And I think that is the most efficient way to go about ticking off your New Year's resolutions if you have them, rather than just coming up with an extravagant list that maybe isn't going to be beneficial to you and that's going to leave you end up feeling disillusioned and disappointed. Another one of the big things that I would like to do in 2022 is get more organized. I think that I'm a very organized person. I'm tidy and clean. My house is always clean. But in terms of organization, although everything is tidy and has a place, I really enjoy watching videos on YouTube and on TikTok of how people organize their lives, their things in their home, so meticulously and beautifully. And for me, that would be a very fun thing. It wouldn't seem like a chore. So I've been looking at that, looking around my house and thinking how I can organize lots of different things. And that is something that I would really like to do, and something that I'd like to start sharing here on YouTube and on my other social media channels, because I think it's something that we all enjoy. It's relaxing, it's fun, and it makes our lives a lot more beautiful and better. In terms of Nicolas Fairford as a business, we'd like to continue bringing out lots more exciting products. The response to Botanica, my scented candle, has been totally amazing. We've had lots of emails, people sending photographs of the candle in their home, people telling us how much they love the scent, so that is amazing and wonderful. But I'd really like to push out more product, something in different price ranges, so that people who couldn't afford the candle can buy something else, so that everybody could have a piece of this in their homes. One of the big things about my brand is that I want to be able to share. So that means allowing people to, on all different budgets, to be able to buy something. So yeah, a lot more product, more videos, more content, and just bringing this community even further and developing together. I think that is my main goal for 2022. So next week is my birthday. I'm going to be turning 32 years old. And to celebrate, I'm going to be doing another giveaway. I did one last year. It was really fun and successful. A lot of people joined in, and it was so nice to be able to give away a beautiful gift. So I've decided to do the same again this year. So if you want to be in with the chance of winning one of my Botanica English Garden candles, tune into Instagram on Monday and I'll be announcing how you can do that. The reason why it's on Instagram is because of the idea that I've got for this celebration. You have to be able to use Instagram to be in with a chance of winning. So do head over to Instagram on Monday to find out how to win one of my candles. I'm really excited to to do that. So I hope that you have enjoyed this video, found it fun and useful. Don't forget to check out Instagram on Monday to see how you can enter the competition to win my candle for my birthday, and I will see you next Friday. Until then, have a really great weekend and a wonderful week ahead. Bye-bye.